Hello guys, I'm going to continue from where I stopped in the last video, like I promised. If you found my videos useful, kindly subscribe, please like my videos and also share with your friends and family. So I'm going to continue with the questions. Are there job opportunities in Poland? Yes, there are job opportunities in Poland as students. So there are different kind of jobs that you can do in Poland, and this is based on your previous experience, what you have to offer. But I would like you to put this in mind that Poland is not an English speaking country, so getting a job for English speakers might be a bit difficult, but this does not mean it is not possible. So you can just do your research before coming into Poland, go to their job website. Look at the requirements, look at everything they have to offer, if this is what you have. And you can also, for students, you can also do jobs that are not corporate job, manual jobs like delivery job. You can work at warehouse, you can work at factory, you can work at restaurant. So there are lots of options. But when it comes to corporate jobs in Poland, it might be a bit difficult. How can I pay my application fee from Nigeria? So you can make use of Send App or you can make use of Gray Finance. I don't know what's happening with these apps these days. Send App has been having the sort of issues sending money to Europe, and then I tried checking Gray Finance today, and the fee that you're going to use to send whatever money you are sending, it's a lot. So if you've sent money from either Nigeria or other African country to Poland before and it has been successful, please kindly drop it in the comment section how you were able to sort out this issue in order to help somebody else. I don't want to stay at the university accommodation. How much does it cost to get an accommodation? So I don't know how much it costs to get an accommodation outside. And like I would always say, use your university accommodation at least for the first semester or even for the first month. And then when you get inside Poland, you can look around and get the kind of accommodation that you want. Can you help me with my cover letter? I'm sorry, I can't help you with your cover letter. It's a lot of work. There are many resources online that you can make use of when it comes to writing application essay. Please ensure that you do not plagiarize any cover letter that you are seeing online. Write whatever it is that you want to write, write it in your own words. But seeing other people cover letter might help you, might give you inspiration on how to combine your words and how to write a good cover letter. As a master's student, can I bring my dependent with me? So for Poland, bringing a dependent with you as a student is difficult. I don't even think it's possible unless your dependent is also coming into Poland to come and study. Aside that, I don't have like any assistance that I can give on that part. Do I need to pay an accommodation fee before applying for visa? No, you don't need to pay an accommodation fee before applying for visa, especially if you are using your university accommodation. But in case your university insists that you need to pay your accommodation fee, then you don't have any choice. You need to pay it so that you can get the necessary documents that you are going to be using for your visa application. I'm interested in applying for a study visa to Poland, and I have few questions regarding the requirements. I've made a series of videos when it comes to studying in Poland, and people have found this video useful by doing it themselves. So if you need requirements about applying to Poland, go through all the videos that I've made. You are going to find all these videos useful. Also, go to the embassy website for the requirements that you need. Go to the university website that you'll be applying to. Check for requirements. So I'm not the one that will tell you the things that you need to do when it comes to documents that you need to submit or what have you. Just go to your university website, go through the videos I've made. They are well detailed, and then you are good to go. And the last question that I have here, what documents do I request from my sponsor? So the documents that you are going to be needing from your sponsor might vary. But definitely, you are going to need a means of identification of your sponsor. You're also going to need document that shows that proves your relationship between your sponsor. You are going to need an affidavit from your sponsor that they will be the one to sponsor you throughout your study in Poland. And I would also advise that you check the video I made on visa documents, like when you're applying for visas, sort of. I mentioned like a list of documents that you should also get from your sponsor. If your sponsor has a business, you also want to get the documents that they used in the registration of their business. So, and also their financial documents also, since that is the person that will be sponsoring you, right? So you need the person's financial document. People have also asked this question, like if you are using a sponsor, do you also need to submit like your own financial documents? If your sponsor has like enough finances to sponsor your study in Poland, you don't need any extra financial documents from your own side again, as long as your sponsor has like enough money in their account to sponsor you, so you don't need to submit like additional documents. So I hope this video helps you. Please do not forget to subscribe. Do not forget to like the video. Also share the video. Bye for now, and I'll see you guys later.